Yeah, coming to more like a customer story from my public. I'm talking about what we are as a company, then looking a bit in the past, in the present, and in the future. My public is, as most of you will know, a Singapore company, a fiber broadband provider in Singapore. We're having our headquarters in Singapore, then rapidly expanded to New Zealand, Indonesia, and then also in Australia. So we are delivering internet access to the customers. In the past, we actually had like our local domains, like for example in Singapore, we had our mypublic.com.sg. And for simplicity, I just included Australia, mypublic.com.au. So we have our user base in the country. Then we had like cloud-based infrastructure. So for example, local answers in AWS. And then our Origin, which were Apache 2 web instances. So pretty simple with country-based domains. Then looking into but more unified user experience would be that we have like providing one domain and not country domains anymore. So we did actually move to mypublic.net. So the same concept as like, for example, Apple, where in US you visit apple.com, then you automatically get redirected to apple.com/US. If you're visiting it within Singapore, it's actually going to apple.com/SG. So the same concept we wanted to implement. So we went to AWS, get our GeoDNS set up in Route 53. So same concept, the user in Singapore will be identified as a Singapore user going to the origin based in Singapore. So that's the past. Click. Click. Okay. So then the edge case would be that a user from Australia, for example, is traveling to Singapore and still wants to order their fiber broadband internet. So how is this going to work if my user is in Singapore, goes to my origin in Singapore, and then sees the Singapore website? So our solution was to have mod proxy implemented. So the user is still getting to our local land on Singapore, goes to the Apache, which then proxied back to Australia. And then the origin will be in Australia serving actually the /au request, which is not a very pretty solution, but it somehow worked. So just a quick overview about the solution as a whole. We have a rewrite rule for /au to make sure that it's always with a trailing slash. So you have /au/, then you configure proxy path based on /au/, redirecting it to the local answer that we just saw within Australia with /au/. Then you define the proxy path reverse. And you also said proxy preserve host so that mypublic.net will always be preserved along the proxying. Now the question is obviously what's the disadvantage, and somehow you have overhead now proxying between countries. You also have a single point of failure, so what happens if a user is in Singapore, the Singapore site fails and then it can't be proxied to Australia. You are adding latency and then it's also kind of hard to troubleshoot. And the other big, big disadvantage is the whole SSL proxy engine, because now you have two Apache instances need to trust somehow each other. So how is the trust going to work? Are you certificate pinning for SSL, or are you allowing only certain CAs? Are you trusting based on the certificate lifetime? So a lot of questions you have to figure out with a proxy engine. But the advantage is it works, I guess. So where we are now, so now we're having our users in different countries. We have the big black box from Cloudflare. Then we still have our origin setup based on the local instance in Amazon, and then our Apache instances, one or multiple, of course. So now we're looking a bit more into the black box of Cloudflare. I'm not listing all the services we are using as my public, but I'm using just, for example, a few. So one important one, obviously, we're still having the GeoDNS to identify our customers from which country they are actually accessing. We are using all the pretty edge location that John previously talked about to identify where the request is coming from. Then we're using page rules, which is actually pretty cool because it's completely web serverless. So we don't have any load on our web server anymore. Now it's all handled by Cloudflare. So what we saw previously with /au goes to /au/. That's a forwarding rule. So that's being done on the edge location. And then doing a simple resolve override, which is actually replacing the DNS answer packet, which is a pretty convenient solution for us. Then, of course, you're using the web application firewall, weight limiting. For example, if you have a content management platform and want to somehow protect them, your login page from various bad guys, so that's what weight limiting is for. Also, the zone lockdown. Pages that are not supposed to be public and only reachable from certain IP blocks can be configured via zone lockdown. And then the obvious caching and speed, what the whole CDN portion is actually for, right? You want your answers to be fast delivered from Cloudflare, and also improving the speed in making your CSS smarter, optimizing your JavaScript, compressing your images, so all the pretty CDN portions. Talking a bit about web security, and I think that's the most important one in our days where we are currently living in, and starting a bit from the DNS portion. So what happens after you port your zone over to a CDN provider like Cloudflare, for example? So it's really easy to get DNS enabled. So before, you had really to configure like zone keys and all the stuff in your DNS, in your bind or whatsoever. So that's really becoming easy. It's just one click, you copy and paste it to your registrar, and then it's like done, and you're forever protected for DNS poisoning, cache poisoning, and all the stuff. That's really easy. The other thing is always use HTTPS. It's pretty convenient as well. Before, you had like writing rewrite rules to actually replace all your HTTP queries to then get a 301 or 302 to HTTPS. So that's all being done on the edge locations already, so you don't need to take care of this part anymore. And the other cool stuff is also to automatic HTTPS rewrite. So actually, the CDN goes in all your HTTP responses and just plainly replace HTTP to HTTPS. So it's already in your source code replaced. And then, of course, the whole HSTS setup. So some of you might know what HSTS is, some of you might not. So HSTS is basically the domain is telling you to never downgrade the security. So if you ever go into an environment where man in the middle could actually intercept your HTTPS traffic and then downgrade to HTTP, then all your traffic would be vulnerable, for example, in a typical hotspot environment where you don't really trust the provider. So that's really bad. So with Cloudflare, it's just a click, and then they're actually taking care that HTTPS specs are set, and your client will then never allow HTTP anymore. So then you can also set the max age. So for how long will your client remember that it's not downgrading connection? You can say if it's applicable for subdomains or not. You can opt in for the preload list within Chrome and the other browsers, for example, and also set the no-sniff header so that the Internet Explorer, sorry, is not mime-sniffing away from your content anymore. Then the other really cool features are actually that Cloudflare is providing a lot of beta features. So if you just want to try it out and give your clients the latest TLS, for example, in this example of 1.3, and then you're just even more secure and providing your client something that, again, you don't even have to configure on your end or compile OpenSSL, link it, you know, don't even need to take care of this port anymore. A bit looking into the future. So one of the newest projects Cloudflare is actually working at is Spectrum. So where they came from was actually just looking at HTTP and HTTPS and then doing all their DDoS prevention and all the funny, funny stuff. But now they're also looking at plain TCP connections, which are not terminated, but just proxied plain through Cloudflare, and then doing all the DDoS prevention on their edges again. So that's something we definitely are evaluating currently and looking into. The other thing is really, at the moment, Cloudflare is having cooperation, I guess, with Komodo to provide Komodo certifications at their edges for all the hosted sites. For the future, we really look forward, actually, for them to implement a bit more of Let's Encrypt. So I think I'm talking a bit about Let's Encrypt. Some of you might know what Let's Encrypt is, some of you might not know. So actually, Let's Encrypt is really cool because it provides you a shorter certificate lifetime. There's one thing. So all certificates have a default lifespan of 90 days. That's important if ever your private key is getting compromised or lost or anything. And at least with a shorter lifespan, you're not relying on revocation lists or anything like this. And the other thing, that it fully automates the whole issuing process and renewal process based on ACME standard. It's an open certificate authority, so it's actually a non-profit organization behind Let's Encrypt, highly funded by the EFF. And yesterday I looked it up, was like more than 70 million active certs. So, and there's no known breach or whatsoever on Let's Encrypt, rather, or compared to like providers like Komodo, where we knew that they actually lost some private keys here and there in the past. The automation part, for what we saw previously, we were using like Amazon, so Route 53, together with their Elastic Load Balancers, and there's actually a project on GitHub provisioning the whole certificates to the load balancers and doing the ACME challenge via DNS. So actually, you're just providing your Amazon API keys to the Let's Encrypt AWS binary, and then the whole challenge, renewal, everything is like fully automated with this project. Because we moved our DNS from Route 53 to Cloudflare, we actually contributed to this project, and one of my teammates actually forked it and did a Cloudflare implementation. So now we are able to have, with our Cloudflare API key, the same seamless certificate issuing, so that the ACME DNS challenge is being provided via Cloudflare. The key, the DNS keys are being generated, then the certificate is being retrieved via Let's Encrypt, deployed and issued, and after, the DNS keys will be removed. So if someone has like a similar setup and don't really know how to automize, then those are definitely the links you want to check out. That's a bit slide of cooperation between Cloudflare and MyPublic going forward. If you have a business in Asia Pacific and looking for a bit more growth, then of course Cloudflare can like scale for you guys. And I guess they have more edge locations here in Asia Pacific on their roadmap as well. So that's something exciting we're looking forward to serve our customers even better, more towards their homes. As I said, scalability is one thing, and then the same user experience, you know. You have just one unified dashboard, and then it's just being provisioned in your edge location, and you don't really care about. Yes, that's my presentation. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Sebastian, for that. And now we would like to invite John back.